Welcome to People. I'm Shirley Lin. Today, my guests are John Hay and Gerard Hay, and they are the chairman and the president of Dale Carnegie Training Program here in Taiwan. Well, first of all, let's welcome them. Thank you so much for coming, John and Gerard.
Yeah,
thank you.
Very glad to be here.
Yeah. Well, we're going to start off by talking about this Dale Carnegie Training. I believe that John is the one who brought this program into Taiwan. So, John, tell us, you know, how exactly did you do it? I know it took you a while.
Sure.
Right? And there were a lot of communication and probably misunderstanding and problems about bringing it in, but you persisted. So how did you do it?
Well, thank you. First of all, I want to thank my wife. Sorry, she couldn't be here. She was the initiator of the whole thing. Yeah, because as a husband and wife, I think wife understands what her husband really wants to do. She knew that I was always interested in training, in sharing, in writing. Yet I was working for a high-tech company then in mid-80s, and then I worked for Acer. It's all high-tech, not a regard with this area. So in 86, my wife saw an article in U.S. News and World Report depicting the Dale Carnegie Training. I remember we were on a freeway in Los Angeles, and she saw it. She showed it to me. This is what you want to do. So the whole thing gets started then.
But I'm really surprised because, you know, you were in high-tech stuff, right?
Yeah.
But she kind of figured that you need something softer. I don't know. This it seems softer in comparison. So why, you know?
You're married, right?
You have
husband,
yes.
Children. I think since we are so close, she knew that what I'm most interested in, for example, where all my free times you were spent with church people, with a youth group, with giving a talk to some social group. Work is okay, but in Chinese we have a good old saying that 事倍功半. You work hard, but you get less, not much.
Okay.
I was like that. So something happened. So she encouraged me to just take a risk.
All right. Well, Gerard, please tell us, what is the Dale Carnegie Training Program?
Yeah, it's obviously a training program founded by Dale Carnegie, Mr. Mm-hmm. Dale Carnegie. Back in 1912, so
right.
We'll be celebrating our centennial next year.
Oh,
like ROC selling it this year, right?
Uh-huh.
So not too many 100-year companies around. So yeah, he actually, when he started, it was in New York, and it's just a program to teach people how to give speech and public speaking class.
Oh,
and
okay.
I guess one day he ran out of material to talk about. So he asked his students to share something and to talk on stage.
Mm-hmm.
And he noticed that that was the most successful session he ran so far.
Oh.
So he began to change the format of his training into where it's very interactive and
mm-hmm.
a lot of practice and participation. And after this went on for a while, he found out that most of his students has problem with human relations and how to communicate, for example, with customer, with boss, even in the family. How do you how do you communicate effectively with your children,
with
your spouse, and husband, wife? So he began to trying to find some material to help him, to help his students. But he found out that at that time, there was no reference material for him to use.
Uh-huh.
So he began to do some research and by experimenting. For example, he would tell one of his participants, oh, try this with your boss. And when the participant come back and tell Mr. Carnegie that, oh, that principle was wonderful.
Uh-huh.
My boss was very pleased.
Effective.
Yeah, very effective. he will write it into his manual.
That's how he came up with all his reference books.
Teaching materials? Yeah, he did some experiments. And then if you give another advice to another participant to use with his wife, and then next week, that participant will come back and say, oh, that was a terrible advice. My wife was so angry. He would cross that out.
Oh, really? But I think that would actually become good teaching material, like what things not to do.
Right. So, and then in 1936, he published his book, How to Win Friends and Influence People.
Wow.
And that would become like a mega hit. And then he began to train other people to teach his program. Mm. And from then on, then it expanded in the United States and later on internationally.
Right.
Yeah.
You know, actually, I personally think that, personal experiences are the ones that are most effective in terms of using that material to teach others.
Mm.
Because it's a personal, what you went through, trial and error. I think those things make up really lively teaching materials other than like really hard kind of textbooks, that come out of, that is just too academic.
Right.
Don't you think? Yeah. So, wow.
Yes.
So how do you think... have you been, did you have to change a lot to accustom it to or to tailor make it to Taiwanese people with this program? Because after all, there's such a culture difference, but not just culture difference. It's just in the habit of the Chinese people and Western people. I mean, John, you probably feel this the most when you brought this program into Taiwan.
Yeah, I was even worried a lot.
Yeah,
I'm
sure. A lot of sleepless nights.
It's an American training program, and what a difference. They said, East is and is East, West is West.
Uh-huh. East is East, West is West.
Yeah. But after the first year, I was so relaxed because people are different. However, there are a lot of a common ground, a lot of commonalities between people. Either Asian, Americans, European, just like Gerard said, for example, people all love and anticipate recognition, compliment, thanks, or appreciation.
Mm-hmm.
No matter whether you are Americans, Japanese, or British, we are all the same.
Okay.
But however, people all hate and dislike, criticism, condemn, complain. So the Carnegie training is based on this common ground, and that's why it lasts so long, it developed to so many areas.
Mm-hmm.
But we did some changes, and in some area, the changes are very...
Minimal?
Very well, rooted, because Chinese people, the big breakthrough is to be more confident in front of people.
Mm. Right.
So some Americans, they had the experience in the primary school, in the high school or college to give presentation.
Mm-hmm.
But not many in Chinese educational system. Therefore, we kind of emphasize on that to have the breakthrough to also, we started, then this is number one in the whole world in the Carnegie system, that is to teach the youth class for high school students, for college students.
Mm, okay.
Because this is one of our uniqueness.
Yeah.
Chinese family, they want to do everything to help their children.
That is so true.
But if it's in U.S., if a kids have the needs to do something in their communication, in human relation, the parents, some, not all, would say, okay, you wait till you get, you work hard on McDonald's, and you earn enough tuition, you go ahead to take their Carnegie training.
Mm.
But the Chinese parents would, whoa, they would pay for it.
Yeah, that is true. I see that, public speaking really is the thing to break through in terms of, someone's intimidation about speaking in front of a group of people.
Mm.
So, Gerard, you would have to set an example first, right? Don't you think?
Yeah.
Before you became the president of, can I say DCT? You don't call
yeah,
it
yeah.
that.
When? Yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay, DCT.
Yeah. Go ahead. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's okay.
So you would have to set an example. Mm. So in order to be convincing about this program.
Yeah.
What was your first time like speaking in public to a huge group of people? What was the experience like, and how many people were there?
Yeah, I took Dale Carnegie when I was attending college, yeah, in mm-hmm. the U.S. And that was when my father was getting ready to set up and learning about Dale Carnegie in the States. And I remember it was quite intimidating because all the people are working, you know, they're managers or professionals, and mm-hmm. I was the only college student in class.
Okay.
So, but in Carnegie, I think there are two things that really help us, you know, to conquer this challenge. Is number one, the trainer is very good at interacting with you, so that, for example, you ran out of things to say,
yeah.
the trainer will ask you a question and then help you continue.
Oh.
And also, the trainer played the role of, you know, always encouraging you to, mm-hmm. to give you a comment to build your confidence
mm-hmm.
after your speech. They always find something good about what you did, and then
so in other words,
build up your confidence.
Encouraging, yeah. always like positive thinking,
right.
encouraging, more and more encouragement. I mean,
yeah.
that's the whole idea.
That's the whole idea.
And
I think this really helped me because, you know, as an Asian student in the U.S., we're really good at taking tests. But one time I attended a class in my graduate school, and the professor said that half of your grade will be final exam, the half of your grade is the number of times you speak in class. And that was a big class. It's like 250 people.
Uh-huh.
So I found that a lot of my fellow students from Far East, they had to struggle with that class because we're not so used to, you know, always
raising your hand,
and speaking out,
making
and
comments, yeah.
Be proactive about making comments.
Right.
And
what about you, though? How was your performance?
Yeah, it was take some used to, but
okay.
I think since I already had the training, so it helped me somewhat to.
Thanks to Dad.
Yeah, to have
well, that's
this.
That's in Yale, right?
Yeah, that was in Yale.
Okay.
Yeah, so that helped me go through with the challenge. Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah, I know. Really, Chinese parents, they just, you know, it's just something about the culture and just parents being very conservative that they don't give as much praise to their children as they should,
yeah.
you know, but a program like this is really great. I'm thinking about my kids. My daughters are not hand raisers in class.
Uh-huh.
they're afraid to ask questions. You know, when the teacher asks them, so do you understand? They always go, nod the head. But my
right.
son is totally opposite. But I don't know what to do with that. You know, it's just so ingrained in the culture and personality.
Mm. Well, send your daughter to Dale Carnegie.
Okay.
Yeah, there's a popular book published recently about the tiger mom.
Yes,
yes. The tiger mom. That's a typical Eastern way to raise children.
Yeah.
And
well,
then,
I'm surprised because, I mean, even though they're, you know, Asian families
mm-hmm.
who actually grew and were brought up in the States, but there's still that Chinese ingrained in them.
Yeah,
I
they
think.
Do the same thing. Yeah,
yeah?
Exactly. Yeah,
oh.
It's very interesting.
So, well, and now this program, you're saying, well, from the very beginning, it's been 100 years next year.
Mm.
But I think you're going to 25 years now since you brought,
yes.
John, you brought Dale mm-hmm. Carnegie into this program, into Taiwan. It was back in 1987.
Yes.
How has it been, and what changes has there been, and how has it progressed? How has it improved? How has it made its mark in Taiwan or on the map?
Yeah, I will answer this question, the first part.
Okay.
Gerard will answer the second
sure,
part.
Sure, sure.
You know, it's a long story. We are going to cut it in a few minutes. let me say that the Dale Carnegie training today, the Chinese one in Taiwan and part of China, is the number one franchise area in the whole world
mm-hmm.
in 25 years. No,
yeah.
actually, since 1993 or 94, we became the number one franchise in the world.
All right.
I can attribute all this to luck or just happened. So I have to say that something we can trace back why we made it.
Yeah.
So the first reason is that what you said, that's how it make a splash reaction when we started in 1987. Mm-hmm. That is, the people in Taiwan have expect this for a long time.
Oh, okay.
Like a volcano, something is burning inside.
So you brought it in just the right timing.
Yeah, we take tap and then explode. Uh-huh. So that's why we were lucky, you know. Not only the parents seldom give appreciation or praise to their children. How about the school teachers from primary to college? They were the same. They seldom praise the kids. So something like Dale Carnegie came to Taiwan, people, you know, with the word of mouth, people just spread around. Oh. We didn't do any marketing or advertising. We just couldn't handle so many people's interest. However, we did have some downside or frustration.
Yeah.
First is we couldn't get it approved through the
government here.
Yeah, because at that time in 86, 87, any money coming in is blocked. So you have to go through investment scrutiny commission.
Yeah, like a bureau for controlling foreign exchange.
To approve any money to ship out. That is the what we call the royalty.
Yeah.
So at that time, only high-tech company or maybe McDonald's can get the money out. We couldn't. So then it has to be approved by the whole commission with the representative from various ministries. But I didn't know where I get this tenacity. I went to talk to every ministry, representative of every ministry, including the central bank. You know?
Oh.
So I didn't know, I know none of them. Uh-huh. So I don't know where did I get the courage to do that. So then it was approved. There are quite other downsides. For example, we didn't have enough instructors, trainers.
Uh-huh.
So we were so too ambitious to get too many trainers. And then some were not good at it. Some just left us, became the competitors. Uh-huh. That's hurting. That really hurt.
Right.
But we survived.
Oh. Well, Gerard, going back on a point that John just said, you know, encouraging these kids to, you know, enroll in this kind of program. Do you ask the parents, do you convince the parents to enroll in this program first before they able to successfully tell the kids to enroll in this program?
Yeah, it's actually our first class 18 years ago was formed by the request of the parents.
Oh.
Yeah, so they graduated from our program. They wanted this for their kids. So we applied to our headquarters for a new experimental program. They approved.
Oh.
So that's how it got started. Uh-huh. And now, like you said, it's reverse. So sometimes the kids take it, and then we will do these previews and kind of to explain the program.
Mm-hmm.
And we will give special discounts to parents so
they,
because we always convince them that, you know, if your children are changing and you don't change your attitude, and you're not growing and developing along with your children. So
surely you have to take it also.
If we give you a special discount.
Right. I will think about it. All right. Wow. Well, okay. That's amazing. Congratulations, you know, going on its 25th year. This year, is it?
Yeah.
I'm trying to do the math here. But thank you very much, and congratulations, and really thank you so much for your hard work and what you've brought to the future of the children in Taiwan.
Thank you.
Thank you,
All right, thank you. And thank you for watching, people. I'm Shirley Lin.